In the last tutorial, I taught you how to make a triangle, so now we're gonna build on top of that by introducing the concept of index buffers. As you hopefully remember, we can draw a triangle by telling OpenGL to use the triangle primitive between three vertices. In this case, vertices 0, 1, and 2. Easy enough, right? But what about this case? Well, here we have three triangles, so that means we need 9 vertices. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. But as you can probably see, we have duplicate vertices, which means that we're just wasting memory space. So let's rewrite the vertices, but this time without duplicates. So in this case, we have vertices 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If we give this to OpenGL, it will draw a small upside-down triangle on top of a big triangle, which is not what we want. In order to prevent that, we need to make use of an index buffer. An index buffer tells OpenGL the order in which it should go over vertices. Here, it first goes over 0, 4, 3, then 4, 1, 5, and then 3, 5, 2. We solve the problem of duplicate vertices by simply visiting the same vertices twice using indices. So now, let's actually implement this. I'll first add the new vertices to my array. And now I'll create an array of data type glint for the indices and type in the indices we saw previously. Generating the index buffer is very similar to the vertex buffer, so let's first create its reference value. Next, let's generate the reference value and store it in evo, specifying we only have one object. In order to do something with it, we need to make it current, aka bind it, and also specify it's of type glElementArrayBuffer. Now we link it to our indices array. If you don't know what these inputs mean, check out my previous tutorial. Now we unbind it, but make sure you unbind it after you unbind your VAO, since the EBO is stored in the VAO. So if you unbind it before unbinding the VAO, you're essentially telling OpenGL that you don't want the VAO to use your EBO. And to keep things clean, we'll delete it at the end of the main function. The last step is to replace glDrawArrays with glDrawElements, specifying the primitive we want to use, how many indices we want to draw, the data type of our indices, and the index of our indices, which in our case is 0. Now just press run and enjoy your triangles. As always, I've left the source code and some exercises in the description. Bye!